Hi everyone, here is Anton and welcome to my channel. Today I will do the final test of the whole script that replaces the public certificate on all components of my lab. I can assure you that I did not try it yet, thus the fingers crossed. As I predicted last time, we don't need a public certificate on the Office Online Server and Certificate Authority because they are hidden behind web application proxy. What we are doing today is running the whole script from the very beginning and hoping that everything goes well. If everything goes well, there will be some tests to ensure that all services are up and running. The testing program I will reveal shortly. Before we start, I would like to discuss a couple of insignificant changes in the script of NTLAB. Firstly, due to the strict requirements for the public certificate on the Skype for Business Edge server, it does not accept filed name certificates, I decided to request two certificates. Now there are two separate certificates, common one for all services and the second one devoted to the public Skype for Business Edge server. And the second tiny change is related to the appearance of the IDFS login page. You will see it. I have made it a little bit branded. Okay, since the replacement of the public certificate affects all the lab services, they all have to be tested. On the screen you can see a testing program which, from my perspective, will reveal all issues, if there will be any. It is vital to run all checks beforehand to be sure that initially there were no problems. I can assure you that I accomplished all these tests off camera. I did it to avoid repeating the same activities that you will see later in this video. And I swear to you that everything worked perfectly well. Anyway, how we are going to test the lab? Firstly, we will access to the called common elements such as the certificate authority and the Office Online server. We will be checked by accessing respective URLs. Those you can see on the screen. This and all the rest of the actions will be performed inside the domain and on a terminal server and outside from a VM on my workstation. I will demonstrate it a little bit later. The Exchange server will be tested by accessing a mailbox via browser. After that, I will configure Outlook profiles and exchange messages between domain users and external mailboxes. And the final test of the Exchange functionality will demonstrate that user can edit Microsoft Office documents directly in the browser and mailbox. Test of the Skype for Business will include access to the scheduler URL, setting up client using AutoDiscover, making a call between these two clients and simultaneously conducting a PowerPoint presentation. In this case, the external user will use my tablet and mobile internet. Let's start. Okay, let's start with the test. First of all, I'd just like to demonstrate that I separated the certificate request for Edge, Skype for Business Edge server in different region, and probably that was only change. Okay, let's run the script and see what will happen. We are requesting a production certificate, and there is standard call down. I will pause my video for a minute just to save space on my hard drive. Almost ready. Let us check. Okay, we can see Acme Challenge DNS record. Hopefully, it is a good sign. Five seconds to go. Okay, it seems that we successfully acquired the certificate and starting to install it on all the servers. Probably I should exclude UC Edge server from this certificate installation because he doesn't need it. removing certificate from the shared folder and starting to install to assign the certificate to services. Let us check that certificate was removed from the shared folder. Yes, it's empty now. Enabling the certificate from the Internet Information Services on the X1, I believe. Yes, X1. It takes some time. Restarting the service. It takes some time. Okay. And here is the second server. Probably this is the most time-consuming part of the script. Well, except that 2 minutes sleeping period when we are requesting the certificate. Exactly what I expected. Restarting the services, and that's absolutely correct. As you probably remember, we replaced certificate twice to avoid necessity to recreate Edge subscription. It seems that we successfully preserved the default SMTP certificate on Edge, replacing the certificate on reverse proxy rules. We are replacing the certificate for HTTP listener with NetSSH. And now we are replacing the certificate for published services on reverse proxies. And now we are starting with Edge Server. We are requesting the second certificate for Skype for Business Edge Server, and I am going to pause the video. Actually, there is one thing I would like to mention about the requesting the certificate for particular names. If we look at our DNS server, it has created a folders for child names and created for each of them a challenge record to prove that we own this record. And it is quite inconvenient because afterwards it will delete the TXT record but not delete the folder. It will leave residues of its activity, and I don't like this. But anyway, it works. As long as it works, I don't mind. 25 seconds to go. And 3, 2, 1. The second certificate was acquired and installed on the Skype for Business Edge server. Yes, currently it has been assigned. Waiting for the services to be restarted, and then we will see the currently assigned certificate. It will take some time. Okay, now I would like to discuss the results of the test. First of all, I decided not to include the footage of the tests just because I feel that I have to rerun them again. The reason is that they were not 100% successful. But the problem was unexpected and not because flaws of the script. I will discuss this shortly. I fixed the issue, but I want to do a clean run in a week and do all the checks according to my testing plan. Well, the issue was quite interesting. Symptoms were quite strange. Two services did not start on the Edge server, Skype for Business Edge server. The event viewer reported that service cannot get access to the private key. I quickly checked the certificate and it seemed that it is okay. The key exists, and even assigning the certificate with Skype for Business server deployment wizard went without any warnings, let alone errors. Thus, the service did not start. However, fallback to the certificate I acquired from the Let's Encrypt a few days ago resolves the problem. Thus, it was obvious that something wrong with the new certificate. I compared them in the MMC console and they seemed 100% identical. However, CertUtil provided me with abundance of invisible properties. Two parameters were different. You can see them on the screen. Generally speaking, Microsoft Software Key Storage Provider means that the certificate uses cryptographic IP Next Generation, in short CNG, which is a long-term replacement for the Crypto IP provider Microsoft Enhanced Cryptographic Provider. According to Microsoft, CNG is designed to be extensible and at many levels and cryptography agnostic in behavior, whatever this means. The articles on Microsoft.com dated 2018, however, this standard much older. For some bizarre reasons, Let's Encrypt decided to issue the certificate using CNG, but only 3 days ago it used the old standard. That is why the issue was absolutely unexpected. It worth to mention that there is a notification in Skype for Business 2015 certificate requirements that CNG certificates are not supported, but Skype for Business 2019 does not have such limitation. Thus, I had somehow to resolve this issue. Firstly, I started looking for options to convert or request the correct certificate with PowerShell. I checked all available information about Let's Encrypt API, unfortunately in vain. However, I came across a workaround to install the certificate from a PayFix file using a particular cryptographic provider with CertUtil. Thus, it was hoped that the native Skype for Business commands might resolve this problem. I was wrong. Even import CS certificate did not convert it to the suitable provider as CertUtil did. Besides this, it is possible to provide the required provider in request of the certificate, but I believe it would make my script much more complex and less reliable. The final and the most time-consuming options would be to update to the Skype for Business 2019. I partly implemented this solution by implementing the newest cumulative update to my current deployment, which is only a couple of months old, without any success. I do not want to go for Skype for Business 2019 because of time required, lack of any benefits, and hardware resources in my lab. Thus, I was forced to resort to CertUtil, and my efforts resulted in additional function. Let me demonstrate it to you. Okay, here is my new function. I call it install LE certificate legacy and use to install the certificate using Microsoft Enhanced Cryptographic Provider first version, which is legacy 2 to some extent. The parameters are quite obvious. I used it many times before, and it's quite clear what they are for and from their names. There was a minor issue related to the decrypting password to certificate file and converting it to the plain text, because CertUtil accepts only plain text passwords. It cannot accept any secure strings or something like that. Therefore, there are a couple of lines which doing the trick. These two functions converted to simple string, and I have googled it. It's not my development, but you can just copy it. And in addition to that, we have to use explicit key when we decrypt password file, just because I know that I use it everywhere. Probably it is not very sophisticated solution, but it works. However, we have to take some additional security measures, therefore we delete the password file immediately after we install the certificate. And script string, which we are going to run by invoke command. Quite clear, except one. We require to provide the name of the cryptographic provider in Hipchens, and therefore we use two or even three of them in a row. This line converts our string into script block, because otherwise it invoke command will throw an error. And probably that is it. Worth to mention that we have to use createSSP, because otherwise we will not get access to the PFX file, because it was deployed on the shared folder. That is it. If someone interested, you feel free to download it from GitHub. By way of conclusion, in this video we checked the script and it seems to work well. Unfortunately, there was an issue related to the need to request two certificates. Besides this, I had to develop an additional certificate installation function to convert the certificate from one cryptographic provider into another. Honestly, I quite annoyed that after 15 years of development, PowerShell still underperforms comparing to such tools as NetSSH or CertUtil. Anyway, it is clear that such an approach did the trick. I hope in the following videos we will quickly run the script and all tests and proclaim the end of this part of the series. I published the updated script on GitHub. Please find the link in the description below. See you next time. Bye.